Hello everybody and welcome to Romanceful's Tarot. I'm about to begin here with a reading. This reading is a general reading, so it may not resonate with everybody. So it's really important to just take whatever resonates with you and just leave the rest of it aside. If ever though you do have any questions, you would like to have a personal reading, please do contact me at romancefulltarot@gmail.com, and it'll be my great pleasure to send you the different type of readings that I can offer you so you can find those answers that you're looking for. Also, if you are new to my channel, or if you've been here multiple times but have not yet subscribed, please do click the subscribe button to show your support to the channel, and it is always grateful. So that being said, we're going to begin this reading here. This reading is entitled, Will He Make a Move? Will He Contact Me? So this is what we want to know. Maybe, you know, you've broken up. Maybe you're just on a pause. We want to know what's going on. Are they going to be contacting you? What I was going to say was the reading is for the sign of Leo. I have not told you. So this is dedicated to the sign of Leo. So with no further ado, I'm using Alice in Wonderland Tarot. I'm using a Halloween Oracle, and I'm using Angel Answers. So let's turn these cards over and let's go see what kind of answers we can get for you. So I have Judgment, I have Seven of Pentacles, I have the Two of Swords, I have the Lovers, I have the Six of Pentacles, Four of Swords, I have the Nine of Swords, and I have the Two of Pentacles. Okay, so, is it possible here for many of you that there was some cheating going on? There was a third party that was involved. I feel as though right now, I feel as though they're still kind of juggling. I feel as though they have left. I mean, they're not with you right now at the moment. You're on a break or on a split up. But I feel as though, and maybe you just, you know, of course you don't know about it, so they haven't told you about it. But I feel as though, you know, and anyways, maybe on a subconscious level, but they are still juggling between two relationships. They're still wondering if they should return to you or if they should continue onto their path alone, which is relationship of convenience, because the relationship that, you know, the other person of the other relationship is not something serious. So well, it's a great question. So you will be seeing if you know, this is if they really are juggling with the two, with the possibility of still wondering if they're going to return with you. That being said, they will be contacting you, that is for sure. So they will be contacting you. At the same time, well, you know, you'll be able to discuss, you'll be able to get your answers. I have here, you know, I have choices. I have so many choices, and I have so many thoughts. You know, I have up here the Seven of Pentacles. I know that there was a lot of work that was put into the relationship to try and make it better, to try and make it survive for a certain amount of time. The Seven of Pentacles is trying to show us that, you know, work has been done, yet the work that has been done has kind of been abandoned by fear of it not really working out, and, you know, being too much effort into something that was not going to work out. So I just decided to let that go. I strongly feel like right now, well, there are so many decisions, so many cards here. I have over here the Two of Swords, who is really just saying that, you know what, I've got myself into this situation. Here I am. I am blindfolded. I have two choices. What am I going to do? But nobody has blindfolded you. You are blindfolded. And I'm sorry, when I'm talking about you, I'm talking really about your partner. This is your partner. Your partner has blindfolded themselves. And this is really about making a choice. But I mean, they're afraid to make the choice, but they're the one who brought this upon them. So it's kind of, you know, funny in a way, but it is not. That being said, here they are trying to make a choice. So they're trying to consciously, because they're kind of afraid, trying to make the choice of what they're going to do. Who are they going to go with? And you know, I have them again. I have them over here balancing the axe out. Here again with the Lovers, it's a choice to be made. I just have choices in like 3-4 of these cards. I have right now, I really believe that, you know, right now the only thing that's going on is that, you know, your partner is trying to relax, trying to put things in perspective, trying to figure everything out. He does know that, you know, something is going to be happening. He's going to have to make a decision. He's going to have to make a choice. But right now, he's just not ready for it. He just wants to relax. He wants to live his life a little bit alone like that. And slowly, whenever he's ready, whenever he's recovered, whenever he's, you know, taken his decision, then, you know, he will move forward, you know, with that decision. But really, I mean, I feel as though beforehand, I know that you've had a lot of nightmares, had a lot of anxiety, a lot of problems sleeping, trying to figure all of this out. You know, I have the judgment over here. This is all about decisions. The whole spread here is all about what he is going to do. He is so confused. He just does not know. And as I said, he put himself into this own situation, yet nothing is quite clear here. Nothing is done. And so really over here with the Six of Pentacles, again, it's a choice, but I mean, both people here are at the table and they are not happy. Neither one of these people are happy at this table. Yet there they are. They're trying to, you know, figure things out. So this was really a little bit, this was before the breakup. Okay. So I'm not really happy, trying to figure things out, trying to see where to go, what to do about all of that. But then this happened, and then they decide that that was it. They were going to leave. It was just not a good idea, and they needed to move forward. So, you know, that's what they've done. But then, you know, here they are again by themselves this time, but really wondering what to do. Anyways, I'm not going to babble about this over and over and over again, because really this is all I see in the cards. This is all it is. It's choices, choices, choices. They don't know. Okay, so right now they just don't know. I'm going to move on to the other cards. Maybe the other ones are going to give me a little bit more clarity. Right here, all I see is that he is trying to figure things out. Let me go see Angel Answers. Listen to your intuition. What is your intuition telling you? In the near future, the situation is going to improve and there's going to be opportunity. So there you go. If I listen to the Angel Answers, they will be coming back. They will be contacting you, and maybe, who knows, maybe an opportunity for a rekindling of the flame, maybe. But anyways, it's not going to be happening tomorrow. It's not going to be happening in a week, but it's going to be happening into the near future. Okay, so sometime soon, your situation, as I said, is going to improve. So right now, I say just leave your partner alone. Let him do whatever he has to do. Let him relax. Let him, you know, figure everything out and take all that murkiness out of his mind, and let him choose, because he's in this big problem of choosing. And if you move too much, or you get into his bubble a little bit too much, maybe he'll just withdraw. So that's not any better. So just leave him do his thing, and you will see, if the angels are right here in the near future, you're going to maybe have an opportunity to get back with him. But in any case, they will be contacting you. I'm going to move over to the final card here, which is the Skull of Stars, which is all about infinite possibilities. And when we're talking about infinite possibilities, we're talking about, it indicates that you need to think bigger and more broadly about your future and what you would like to achieve. Perhaps there's false beliefs, often old, that no longer serve you, or as you grow and as you change in time. So sometimes these beliefs may not even be yours. They may even be imparted to you by, you know, somebody else, community, parents, yet they feel, you know, rather incongruent to you. So you need to just go with your heart and soul, to live the life that you want and honor your own wishes and truth. So that being said, this does conclude this reading. I hope that you enjoyed it. I hope it made sense to you. If you do have any questions and you would like to have a personal reading, please do contact me at romancefulltarot@gmail.com. In the meanwhile, I do wish you a fantastic day. Many, many blessings. Thank you for being there, and I will be seeing you soon.